Alex is a storyteller. And what fascinates me is this plot device that you used. You explored mass media. The opening is the television show, we're talking about pedophilia. Okay, and the focus is whatever, which camera goes next.
Yes.
We go, again, the radio show. I mean, as the cinema viewer, we are privileged to see the tics, or the obsessions, or the psychological tics. Radio, mass media. Then you're taking us to one of the oldest forms, theater. The character we see is the woman in a straitjacket. So kind of like, you know, all of this. Where is this, like, you know, there's tons of violence, and then this idea of media, mediated violence or whatever, and as a plot device, as a plot device that carries us through 2 hours of watching. Can you elaborate a little bit more on that? I know you're an instinctive, intuitive writer, but I would like to know a little bit more about it.
Well, look.
It's just about the characters. Well, I've condemned them into this to you, so that alone links them. And I mean, a lot of the time, their problems are also related to their work, really. It also shows the pressures of the job in the media, how it can literally take a hold of you, you know? That's my answer. I have to, from my end, you know, does that make sense? I don't know. But that's what I meant by it. That's why I made those choices in the beginning. Did I answer?
You referred to as a metaphor.
Yes.
When the pigeon landed, I mean, here you have a dead pigeon. I mean, you're opening the movie with glorious background,
yeah.
And the dead pigeon lands on the piano,
yeah.
And we get a lovely musical score, and then again, we assume, like, you know, the next scene, if I remember it correctly, we are part of a television show on pedophilia, and,
yeah.
You know, the psychiatrist or whatever is the guest star, and like, okay, what just happened? Exploring mass media, you go to the radio show, and kind of like, you know, the topics are topics discussed in mass media.
And the sensation of it as well, the sensationalism of the, you know, of the television show and their topics, and then animal cruelty and immigration. And I always think too, from the sense that with my character specifically, can't really relate one-on-one, but can relate to the masses, you know? But he's apparently not gonna offer more of an explanation than that, but it's a great observation.
Sorry, go ahead.
Sorry, so from the point of view of the characters, I think, it's something very similar in them that, so to speak, their psychological problems go public.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she fades totally on stage. He suddenly has to make this confession, if it's fake or pressure or not, we don't know exactly.
Yeah.
You know, everything seems in public. Bodo, you know, working with little children, fades totally in his show.
Mm-hmm.
So it's something that it doesn't remain in the family, it's somehow it becomes a bit bigger than that, perhaps.
In the way, like with DJ Trim, the way his sort of inner sanctum is invaded, you know, by that other character, and he's kind of forced, you know, out into the open to reveal himself. You know, I mean, it's all very well done, Chris.
Like, you know, we're only in this, like, you know, booth in the radio station or whatever. Yeah, super, you know, that's all. Anyway.
Thanks for that, man.